Continuing on with weapons of the enemy. We previously discussed the Simonov rifle, also known as the SKS, and we talked about how in the history of the Russian military, their Russian rifles kept getting shorter and shorter. You had the Mosin Nagant, which was very long. Then you had the SKS, which was a little bit shorter than that. And then you had the AK, which is much more compact than both, obviously, the Nagant rifle or the SKS rifle. The 7.62 by 39 cartridge, by the time Mikhail Kalashnikov decided to start working on this gun, he and his team, the 7.62 by 39 Russian was an established cartridge. They said, hey, this is what we want to go with. This is a good cartridge. They said, all right, we'll build a gun around that cartridge. 47 obviously stands for 1947, which was when they officially had finished and adopted this rifle. So the Simonov rifle, if you think about it, only really had about 4 years in the sun as the number one rifle before Mikhail Kalashnikov came along and designed his baby. Now the original gun, AK-47, after so many years, they made a few modifications, not really big deal modifications, but few slight modifications, started calling it the AKM. The AKM, the Chinese made the Type 56, and so on and so forth. I think the Russians are up to like an AK-105 now, 104, 105, and so on and so forth. Of course, as we know right now, the Russians are using the 5.45 by 39, which came from the original AK-74, which they don't even use anymore. Now, like I said, they're like AK-100s, 103s, 105s. But the AK-47 or the AKM was the premier battle rifle for communist insurgents during the Cold War, whether it was in Southeast Asia where the Chinese were supplying them, or in Africa where the Russians were supplying them, Soviet Union, Warsaw Pact, whatever. Don't forget the Chinese though. The Chinese were in Africa and they were spreading hate and discontent with their communist people's revolution. So if you ran into a ZANLA or ZIRPA or even FREMLO, communist terrorists, or tares as they like to call them, if you ran into them, they might have a Soviet AK, they might have a Polish AK, they might have a Czech AK, they might have a Chinese AK. Regardless, they all use the same magazines, they all function the exact same way, and they pretty much look the same. So all of your top tier units, your top tier communist rebel terrorist units would have been issued AKs, very simple. Hardwood stocks, which were later replaced by polymer stocks. Some of the originals had polymer grips, or hardwood grips, polymer grips. 30 round magazines, very, very standard. The very ingenious thing about the Kalashnikov design is it's pretty much universally ambidextrous. You say, well, if I'm a left-hander, I can't reach the safety. Wow. That was hard. Did you see how hard that was? I'm a left-hander. Pretty hard. I'm a right-hander. Take my pinky, my middle finger. Boom, take that off. The magazine release is obviously ambidextrous. You can get to it with either hand. If you were a lefty, you would just reach up, rack it like this. If you're a righty, you come under, rack it like so. This Cold War era load-bearing vest that I'm wearing is designed for the AK. Obviously, we used this before. We talked about how it fit the Vector magazines, but you've got your standard steel magazine right there. These either came in 3 or 4 magazine versions. If you see the 4 magazine versions, they usually just have 1 grenade pouch on each side, and the 3 mag versions have 2 grenade pouches. I'll pop this open for you guys so you can see it. Right there. So, got my Granada right there. Who else used the AK besides the enemy? Did the good guys during the Rhodesian Bush War use the AK? Absolutely they did. If you know, if you're a history buff, you should know about the Selous or the Selous Scouts. And the Selous Scouts were a very, I would say, hardcore, serious special operations unit. And the Selous Scouts dressed exactly like their enemy. They used the same guns, the same gear. They wore basically the same type of clothing. And they operated behind enemy lines. They would raid the rebel communist camps and bases in the countries that were launching attacks against Rhodesia. So in addition, so the AK, you could say, well, during the Bush Wars, during the African Bush Wars, you saw an AK and you knew, hey, that dude is a bad guy. But not always. There were times when the good guys also used the AKs, and in the Rhodesian Bush War, the Selous Scouts were the number one good guys using this rifle right here. Hey there, folks. Thanks for watching the video. I hope that you enjoyed it. Now I'd like to personally invite you to join us at GetSOTG.com. Sign up today and you'll never miss another article, radio show, or video. That's GetSOTG.com. Thanks a lot.